Good morning, students. Today, in this video, we will learn active and passive voice for interrogative sentences. By the end of this video, you will be able to differentiate between interrogative, active, and passive voice. You will also learn how to transform active voice interrogative into passive voice and vice versa. Now, first we will discuss types of interrogative. Interrogative sentences are of two types. The first starting from helping verb and the second starting from WH words. Is he eating food? Are you going? Have they helped you? All these questions are starting from helping verb. How are you? When will you come? Who teaches you English? All these questions are starting from WH words. Now we will discuss the rules how to change interrogative active voice into passive voice. If your active voice question is having do or does, then do or does will change into is, am, are. And if your active voice question is having did, then did will change into was or were. If your active voice question is given in simple future, then we will add the word be, and if it is given in continuous form, then we will add the word being in the passive question. If your active voice question is given in perfect tense, then we will add the word been in the passive form. Next, we are going to discuss a very important rule. While changing the interrogative sentences from active to passive, we have to change subjective case into objective case. The reason for this change is that subject of active voice becomes the object of passive voice. So, in passive voice, subjective case will change into its objective case. I will change into me, we will change into us, you will remain you, she will change into her, he will change into him, and they will change into them. Now we will discuss how to change interrogative sentences into passive voice. If a sentence is given in the simple present tense, then we have to add the helping verbs is, am, or are. We will understand with the help of examples. Now, as you can see in the first example, does he help you? Here, does is your question word. We'll circle it. He, subject, single underline. Action word, help, double underline. Object is you, triple underline. We'll follow the same procedure. Now, you will come in the beginning. He will go to the last. And help will change into its V3 form. Add then question mark will come. Now, here we have to add helping verb according to our subject. Now, this you has become now subject. With you, we will use are. And before him, we have to add the word by. So, our sentence will become are you helped by him. Similarly, now we will do the second sentence. First, we will read the sentence. Who teaches you English? Who is your question word? We are going to circle it. In this question, we have no subject. So, we will not do any single underline. Teaches is your verb, double underline. You and English both are your object. Who will change into by whom? After this, you have to add your helping verb. After by whom, since English is going to come in the beginning, so with English, we will use is. By whom is English? Teaches will change into taught. So this question will become, by whom is English taught to you? At the end, question mark. Now we will discuss rule 2. If your active voice is given in the past tense, that means your question in the active voice is given in the past tense, then in the passive voice you have to add helping verbs was or were. This means that your did will change into was or were. We'll do in the similar way as we have done the previous. Read the first. Did he help you? Here did is your question word. We're going to circle it. He is your subject, single underline. Help is your verb, double underline, and you is your object, triple underline. Now, did will change into was or were. As you know that your you will come in the beginning, he will go to the last, and the subjective case will change into objective case. So, objective case of he is him. At the end, question mark will come. Help will change into helped. With you, we will use were as helping verb. So, a question will become, were you helped by him at the end? Question mark. Similarly, we will do the second sentence. In the second question, it is given, when did he help you? Again, when is your question word? Whenever you are given the question words in the beginning, like when, where, why, who, it will remain same. Only who will change into by whom, rest all the question words will remain same. So when will remain same. After when we have to use some helping verb. Now did here will change into was or were. You will come in the beginning, so according to it did will change into were. When were you will come here, help will change into helped by objective form of he is him. So the answer will become, when were you helped by him? Question mark at the end. Now we will discuss a third type, active and passive interrogative for simple future. After will or shall, we have to add one more word, that will be be. Be will be added in the answer. Now we will do first question. Will he help you? Here will remain same. It will not change. He is your subject, single underline. Help verb, double underline. You object, triple underline. Now you will come in the beginning. Will you? Help will change into helped, and he will become him. We have to add the word be, which will come before the word helped. So the answer will become, will you be helped by him? Question mark. Now we'll do the second case. In the second question, who is given? As we know that who always changes into by whom. In this case, this is our verb, this is object. As there is no subject, so we will not add any subject. After by whom, we have to add helping verb. By whom will, after then your object will come in the beginning. By whom will you be helped? Question mark. Now, we will do some more examples of interrogative active voice into passive voice for simple present, past and future tense. Simple present tense. Now let's see the first example. Who looks after the patients? Whenever in a question we are given word who, in that question there is no subject. So we have not done any single underline. Who is a question word, so we have circled it. Action word looks, so we have done double underline. After is a preposition, and the patient's object, so triple underline. Now we are going to convert it into passive. Who will change into by whom? After by whom, we have to add helping verb. Now looks is a present form of verb, so we will add some present helping verb. The patients will come in the beginning, so after by whom, we will add the word are. After are, the patients will come. Looks will change into looked, and after our verb, we will add our preposition. Now our answer will become, by whom are the patients looked after? Question mark. Now we'll do the second question. Do you like this book? Do is a question word, so we have circled it. Who, you, subject, single underline. Action word like, double underline. What, this book, triple underline. Now here, this book will come in the beginning.
like will change into liked. You will go to the end. Now, this book is singular, so here we will use is. So our answer will become, is this book liked by you? Question mark. Okay, the third example. Does she teach you? Does is a question word, so we have circled it. Who, she, subject, single underline. Action word, teach, double underline. Whom, you, object, triple underline. Now here, you will come in the beginning. She will go to the last and it will become her. Teach will change into taught. Now with you, we will use here are. Are you taught by her? Question mark at the end. This is the fourth example. Does he kill the birds? Sorry, does he kill the bird? Here does is a question word. We have circled it. Who, he, subject, single underline. Action word, kill, double underline. What, the bird, triple underline. Now here, the bird will come in the beginning. Kill will become killed. He will go to the last and it will become him. As you know that do or does changes it to is, am or are. The bird is singular, so we will use here helping verb is. Our answer will become, is the bird killed by him? Question mark at the end. The last example, do you need a car? Now here, a car will come in the beginning. Need will change into needed. You will go to the last and it will remain you. And then question mark. Now with a car, we will use helping verb is. So our answer will become, is a car needed by you? Question mark at the end. These are examples of simple past tense. Now in simple past tense, we know that we have to change did into was or were. We'll do the first example. Did he break the window? Here did is a question word. We have circled it. Who, he, subject, single underline. Break, action word, double underline. What, the window, triple underline. Now here, did will change into either was or were. The window will come in the beginning. He will go to the last and it will become him. Now with the window, as it is singular, we will use the word was. Was the window broken by him? Question mark at the end. The second question. Why did she beat the servant? Now here the question word is why. Whenever we are given question words like why, whom, where in the beginning, it will remain same. So why will remain why? Did will change into was or were according to our object. The object is servant. It is singular. So we will use here was. Why was, the servant will come here. Why was the servant, beat will change into beaten. By, she will change into her. So our answer will become, why was the servant beaten by her? So the third question, did the servant break the glass? Did is a question word, so we have circled it. Who, the servant, subject, single underline. Break, action word, double underline. What, the glass, object, triple underline. Now again here, did will change into was or were. The glass will come in the beginning. With glass, we will use was. So our answer will become, was the glass broken by the servant? At the end, question mark. So the fourth sentence. Did Rohit invite you? Did use your question word, so we have circled it. Who, Rohit, subject, single underline. Action word, invite, double underline. To whom, you, object, triple underline. You will come in the beginning. Rohit will go to the last. With you, we will use here were. So answer will become, were you invited by Rohit at the end? Question mark. Now the last sentence of this type, why did she pluck the flower? Now here, why is the question word? It will remain here only. Did will change into was or were. Since the flower will come here, so with the flower, we will use the word was. Was the flower being plucked by her? Question mark at the end. Now, these are the examples of simple future tense. We will do it one by one. See, the first, will they win the game? Here will is a question word, so we have circled it. Who, they, subject, single underline. Action word, win, double underline. What, the game, object, triple underline. Now, will remain here only. The game will come in the beginning. Win will change into one. And they will change into them. Now, we know that whenever we are given will in the question, we have to add the word be. So, our answer will become, will the game be won by them? Question mark. Now, see the second. Will you teach her? Here also, will remain will. Her will come in the beginning and it will become she. Teach will change into its V3 form, taught. And you will remain you in the end. Answer will become, will she be taught by you? Question mark at the end. Now, the third question. Who will do it? Now, here, who is given? So, there is no subject in the question. Will do is your action word and it is your object. Now, who will change into by whom? After by whom, we have to add helping verb. So, we will add will here. Now, it is your object. It will come here. So, our answer will become, by whom will it be done? Question mark at the end. The fourth question, who will cook the food? Again, here who is given, so there is no subject. Will cook is your action word, so it is verb. The food object, so we have done triple underline. Again, who will change into by whom? After by whom, we have to add helping verb. So, we will use here will. Now, this object will come in the beginning. It will become subject. By whom will the food be cooked? Question mark at the end. So the last sentence, will she do it? Now, here will remain will. It will come in the beginning. Do will change into done. She will go to the last and it will become her. Now, will is given over here. So, we have to add the word be. So, our answer will become, will it be done by her? Question mark at the end.
I hope you all have understood the rules for active and passive voice for interrogative present, past and future tense. In the next video, we will discuss the next rules. Now, following these rules, do related exercises of chapter 17, active and passive voice from your basic English grammar and composition. Thank you.